In this video, I want to introduce the velocity function in one dimension. So the velocity function is also a vector function of time, which means that you input some time into this function and then it outputs a vector. So what does this vector tell you? The magnitude of this vector tells you the speed of the object, and the direction of this vector tells you the direction the object is going at that instant. Well, that's useful information. How do we go about getting that? Given a position function of time, x of t, the velocity function in time, and I'll give it a subscript x, saying that it's also in the one dimension, which I'm calling x, this velocity function of time is equal to the time derivative of the position function of time. That's it. This is a fundamental definition. In fact, it's so important that it's best to be remembered just in words instead of equations, because this could be any type of notation and it'll change when it goes to 3D, etc. But the actual definition is the same in words regardless of what your mathematical representation is. The velocity function is the time derivative of the position function, and regardless of the dimension you're in or the axis you're on, this statement is always true. Let's say I have a position function of time given by 2t minus t squared, x is in meters, t is in seconds. And so the velocity function of time is the derivative of this. I can differentiate a polynomial, 2 minus 2t. Note, if this is in meters, then the velocity is in meters per second. I have a meters here in the numerator, and then there's a time in the denominator. So if I'm in meters and seconds, my velocity is in units of meters divided by seconds. Let's introduce some terminology similar to what we did with the position function of time. What is the initial condition of this function? The initial condition of the velocity function of time is defined to be the velocity when the time is equal to zero. And this has some subscript x if I'm along the x-axis, it'd be subscript y if I'm along the y-axis. And so I might give this its own notation, which I might call v sub x zero, which I call v sub x naught, is how I just say that in words. And so for this function up here, that is going to be equal to 2 meters per second. It's the value of this function when t is equal to 0, which happens to be 2. Sometimes I'm not necessarily interested just when the time is equal to 0, but I'm interested in two points in time, which I'll call the initial time t sub I and some final time t sub f, sub I t with a subscript I, and then final time t with a subscript f. With my initial time, I can define now an initial velocity. My initial velocity, which I might identify with v sub xi, is going to be the value of my velocity function v sub x at the initial time t sub I. And then I will have some final velocity, which I might identify if it's along the x-axis, v sub xf, and that's going to be the value of the velocity function at the final time. And then, of course, I might want to calculate the velocity difference, delta v sub x. That's going to be the final velocity minus the initial velocity, which is the velocity function evaluated at the final time, minus the velocity function evaluated at the initial time. As an example, let's look at an initial time equal to 2 seconds, and then I can calculate my initial velocity, which is the function evaluated at t sub I. So that's v sub x evaluated at 2, which is equal to, that's here, 2 minus 4 minus 2 meters per second. Note that this is still a vector function of time, so that I'm in one dimension, then the magnitude is the absolute value of the number, which is 2, and the sign gives me the direction of the vector, which is in the negative x axis. I'll call that as my positive x-axis. My velocity vector then points in the negative x-axis and it has a magnitude of 2 meters per second. Remember, this is not a displacement vector, but it's just a vector of magnitude given the speed, 2 meters per second, and is pointing in the negative x direction. My final time, let's say that's 3 seconds, I can calculate my final velocity, the function evaluated at 3, which is then equal to, so that gives me 2 minus 6, or minus 4 meters per second. At 3 seconds, I have a vector whose magnitude is 4 meters per second, and it's pointing in the negative x direction. So finally, if I wanted to calculate the velocity difference, that's going to be the final velocity minus the initial velocity. Well, that's minus 4 meters per second minus a minus 2 meters per second, which is going to be a negative 2 meters per second. The velocity difference is also a vector, which is in this case has a magnitude of 2 meters per second and is pointing in the negative x direction.